We've reached out to him, and we've managed to contact him, and he's here with us this morning. And I got to say, Russell, it is so nice to hear from you. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm good. I haven't seen anybody that was actually in Fort McMurray other than family since we've evacuated, which is weird. It just struck me this morning that I was at an event at your colleagues at CBC Radio yesterday, and Amy Heff was there. She's a singer from Fort McMurray, but she actually lives in Calgary. So I don't know how I'm going to react, you know, when I see colleagues and friends from back home. A group of our United Way friends met up in Edmonton for the first time yesterday, and there were hugs and tears. And it's pretty incredible what's happened the last week.
Oh, it is. And Russell, you and your family right now, you guys are out in Calgary, but when we were talking with you there last Wednesday, this was just right after the evacuation, and you and your family were separated because they ended up going up to just north of Fort McMurray. And then I think it was day after we had chatted, or 2 days later, I seen the photo of you and your family up on Facebook, reunited, the smiles.
Yeah.
When
we last talked, I was at the Mark Amy Center just south of Anzac. And after getting off the phone that morning, essentially I heard a rumor that we were also going to get evacuated potentially. And so I reached out to my brother-in-law just to get his advice because he's working a scene. He said, yeah, you should probably get south, as far south as you can, just in case. And so I hopped in the car that Wednesday and beetled down to Edmonton while my family was even further north, so I was getting farther away from them. The following day, it was the same day. So Heather and the boys were figuring out, okay, what do we do? How do we, you know, so what they ended up, a friend from Fort McMurray managed to find them flights on the CNRL flight to Calgary. And we reunited on Thursday morning. And that picture that you speak about is quite a moment, you know, hugging your family for the first time. It was 2 days, but it felt like forever.
Oh, I couldn't imagine. And really couldn't imagine what people had to do and what they had to endure, you know, to get to safety. But then realize, where are we going? What's happening next with us?
And then where did everybody end up? You read so many stories of various things. A friend of mine, his wife had just had surgery, and she's at her house in Abbasand, and he had to rush back home, and they grabbed what they could in seconds, got out to their car, and then it ended up moving, and the fire's all around them, and police are going car to car saying, get out and run. I mean, I can't even imagine that. And, everybody has, I mean, there's a million stories, well, maybe not a million, but about 88,000 stories of what happened that day. And I'm just grateful to be here and grateful I sort of was able to get back painting again, Wally, and which felt really good for me, as you know,
that's
sort of my happy place. And the painting has turned out to be kind of an unexpected part of the story. And I finished the Chief Dan George painting that we started at Mark Amy Treatment Center, and that is going to raise money for the recovery efforts. And then I did a painting of a horse after that with my niece, Julia. And that really represents all the pets that are involved in this incredible thing. And then I painted Chief Darby Allen. Did you see that painting, Wally?
I did, actually. I seen it on the local news that I think, what was it, just earlier in the week? It was amazing.
Yeah, it was amazing. I put it up on Facebook and such at 11 o'clock that night, and by the time I woke up in the morning, it really truly got viral, seen by millions of people. Was on the national news, regional and provincial news, and so everybody liked, I think they were ready for something positive, and this painting seems to represent really not just Chief Darby and his heroism, but the heroism of hundreds of men and women that got us to safety. And it will be given as a gift to Chief Darby and the department at some special ceremony down the road. And what we've done, Wally, is we're making prints available of this painting because there was a huge outcry. People wanted to get that. And we're doing it Only by donation. So if you make a donation to the UnitedForFortMcMurray.ca campaign, which is all about the recovery and rebuilding our social infrastructure, you can get one of these prints. And if, depending on how much you donate, if you're well off and you can donate $1,000 or more, what we're going to do is we're going to have a special signing ceremony down the road where all of those prints at that level will be signed by myself, Chief Darby, and as many of the first responders as we can gather for a special signing ceremony. So that'll be a very special piece.
What a great way to turn something so tragic into a positive event.
And it's been a great response so far. And I have to think about what the best way to go about it is. If you look at my art page or the Fort McMurray United Way page, you'll see all the details. Russell Thomas Art on Facebook, and just click on the link about the prints, and you'll get all the details of how to make it happen, how to get your donation, and we'll give us a little bit of time because our staff are scattered all over God's Green Acre right now, but we're doing our best to keep up.
Russell, we also have your link up on our webpage as well, so folks could, if they can, or if they want, they could go through there too. I do got to ask, you know, you and your family do have a home to go back to.
We do.
You do.
We do. But many of our friends do not. And I think we're still learning. We have a sense of some of those, but a lot of them don't. And they're going through a whole different experience than we are.
Yeah.
And they're trying to normalize as best they can, you know, getting their kids in school and figuring out next steps. And there's a lot of unknowns, Wally. We don't know a lot of things. We don't know when we're going to go back. We can only speculate at this point. We don't know how bad the infrastructure piece is with the gas lines and the electricity and the water. That's what they're trying to figure out right now. And I think we're just going to try to keep making the best of this situation and hold each other close. And my wife had to go to Edmonton for a series of meetings for a few days. It was really hard for her to leave.
Yeah.
And we're all at some level going through shock. And I was on the phone with Mayor Melissa the other day, and I lost it. You know, and I've lost it a couple other times when I see the jar at the store with the asking for donations for Fort McMurray. And we're all going through that. And that's normal. And I think we should talk about it because, you know, the more we can just have it out in the open, there's no stigma attached to what trauma that we're all going through and how difficult it can be to go through such a devastating event.
Yeah. You know, Russell, I was thinking when people are allowed to go back and they go back to their homes, you think of those others that don't have a home to go to. What I sort of wonder what the next steps will be for those folks who don't have a home. A couple of neighborhoods are gone.
Yeah, and you know, even if you know your home is gone, that moment when you're standing there, and one of my friends had that experience, it's a whole different level of devastation.
Mm-hmm.
Standing in front of what used to be your home. There's a photo of firefighter Anthony Hoffman standing in front of the home that he grew up in.
Yeah.
And it's just, it breaks my heart, right? But I guess the next steps will be for the authorities to figure out what can they do in the interim, whether it's temporary housing or maybe it's a big sort of work camp right in the community where people can live while we rebuild. But we will. We will rebuild. And Fort McMurray, everything has changed about Fort McMurray in a very short period of time. You know, we've often struggled with our reputation across the country.
Yeah.
All of a sudden this week, the outpouring of support globally. We had messages from the Pope and the Queen and people across Canada reaching into their pockets by the millions to help. Man, we are so grateful, and we're ready to get back to work, rebuild our community, and we're going to be strong going forward, guarantee it.
Yeah, and obviously right there's some sort of solace with, you know, people reaching out and complete strangers wanting to help out in any way. And these folks that don't have a home to go back to, I'm sure when they are allowed to go back, they're going to want to be there. They're going to want to see firsthand what had happened. And I'm sure just being back there is going to give them a little bit of comfort, and it's going to allow them to eventually start that healing process?
Yeah, I think it's the closure that's required. Mm-hmm. You've got to see it in order to move on. And that'll happen. I'm sure that the authorities, once they do the re-entry process, will allow people to come and see their properties. And but again, I can't thank the generosity of the hearts of the businesses and the people. It's been overwhelming on so many levels. So many amazing stories. So our deepest gratitude.
There's been a lot of stories and, you know, a lot of great stories also coming out of this. Now, Russell, just, you know, to ask you, when you're not talking with the media and when you're, you know, have some downtime to yourself with the family, I'm sure there's been a lot of talk amongst you and your wife and the kids as to what's been going on and how they've been handling the situation. Has there been times where you've been allowed to just step back and enjoy some downtime and have some fun time as a family?
I wouldn't describe it as fun for me quite yet. But last night, I was painting a picture of Alfred Hitchcock just because, while my son Ben was drawing the same picture at the dining room table and it was quiet and jazz music was playing, and for the first time in 7 days, I felt a sense of peace and balance. That felt really good. It has been the busiest, most intense week I've ever experienced by a country mile, and I'm trained for it. You know, I probably did 30, 40 media interviews from around the world. My whole life has kind of led to this event, and then the painting thing again has contributed to the events, and I'm just going to. A place to give back in some way and feel somewhat useful. A lot of people are just twiddling their thumbs, figuring out what do we do, right?
Yeah.
So I'm grateful. I had something to do, and last night was nice. It's a nice moment of quiet.
Excellent. And that's all part of, again, the process of being able to move on. And then also having to be patient, right? Because, I mean, it's like this is something that doesn't happen all that often. So.
You know, you're right. We have to take it one day at a time. In fact, mm-hmm. we have a family meeting here because we're staying with Heather's brother's family. And we talk about the week ahead and who's doing what and how can we keep our sons busy and how do we all help each other get through this. And we're going to take it one week at a time. That's our approach. And it's worked so far, and I'm sure it's going to work as we anticipate going back home. If I was to guess, maybe this is like River Break, going to have a guess as to when we get to go back home. But I'm thinking it's going to be early June, maybe mid-June. Maybe I'm being optimistic, but that's where my gut is saying we're going to go back, and we'll see what happens.
And like you said, one day at a time.
It's all you can do. It's all you can do. And I know that, you know, while we're on the radio, and I know people from Fort McKay might be listening, my deepest thanks to the community of Fort McKay because, and specifically my son's mother for arranging accommodation for my wife and son Ben in the barge landing camp owned by the McKay First Nation. They didn't have a place to go, and they provided that on that first night, and I'll be forever grateful for that.
Russell, I want to thank you so much for speaking with us this morning. And again, yesterday we had that little problem, but I'm glad that we were able to make that connection and just to get an update from yourself to see how things are going.
Well, thanks, Wally. And again, the website, if you want to contribute to the recovery effort that I'm working on with my colleagues, United Ways across the country, is unitedforfortmcmurray.ca. And if you're interested in getting one of those prints, what's going to happen is if you make a donation of $100 or more, you're going to get an email that says, would you like to have one of these prints? And if you say yes, we're going to, with some great support from companies like Run Digital here in Calgary and others, we're going to send one to you, and you're going to be helping a great cause in the process.